In this video, we're going to finish the polygons and angles worksheet on the CUDA software website under the geometry section. There will be a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. Our directions are to find the interior angle sum for each polygon. Round your answer to the nearest tenth if necessary. Remember that the sum of interior angles is equal to the number of sides in minus 2 and that quantity multiplied by 180. So in number 21, you can see that the number of sides in is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So I'm going to plug 7 in for in and then calculate. So 7 minus 2 times 180 equals 5 times 180, and that's going to equal 900 degrees. So 900 degrees is my solution in number 21. In number 22, the number of sides is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So I'm going to take 10 and plug that in for n. So I'll have 10 minus 2 times 180, since my formula is n minus 2 times 180. 10 minus 2 is 8, so I'll have 8 times 180, which is equal to 1,440 degrees. So the sum all the interior angles is 1,440. And remember, if I wanted to find just one of those interior angles, I would just divide that total by the number of sides. So dividing 1,440 degrees by 10, I would get that one interior angle is 144 degrees. However, for this part, we're finding the sum. So continuing on to number 23, I have a pentagon and the number of sides is 5. So 5 minus 2 times 180 will give me the sum of the interior angles. 5 minus 2 is 3. 3 times 180 equals 540. So 540 degrees is my solution in number 23. In number 24, the number of sides on this polygon is 8. So I'll have 8 minus 2 and that quantity times 180. 8 minus 2 is equal to 6. And 6 times 180 will give me 1,080. So 1,080 is my solution in number 24. In number 25, the number of sides in is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11 minus 2 times 180 is equal to 9 times 180, which equals 1,620 degrees. And number 26, the number of sides in is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So 9 minus 2, that quantity, times 180 will give me the sum of the interior angles. 9 minus 2 is equal to 7, and 7 times 180 equals 1,260 degrees. So 1,260 degrees is my solution in number 26. In number 27, we have a regular quadrilateral, and we know that the angles within a quadrilateral add up to 360 degrees, so we can just write 360 degrees. And if you want to double check 360, quadrilaterals have 4 sides. So you do 4 minus 2, which equals 2, and multiply that by 180 to get 360. Let's go on to number 29. In a regular dodecagon, we will have 12 congruent sides and 12 congruent angles, since a dodecagon has 12 sides. So n is 12, and we'll have 12 minus 2, and we'll multiply that by 180. That'll be 12 minus 2, which is 10, times 180, which will give us 1,800 degrees for the sum of the interior angles. In 28, n is 18. So 18 minus 2 times 180 equals 16 times 180, and 16 times 180 equals 2,880. So 2,880 degrees is the solution for number 28. And lastly, for this set of directions, number 30, we have 15-sided polygon that is regular. So we'll do 15 minus 2 times 180. 15 minus 2 is 13, and 13 times 180 equals 2,340. So 2,340 degrees is the sum of interior angles in a 15-sided regular polygon. Now moving on to our critical thinking questions. It says, what is the exterior angle sum of a 500-gon? Remember that the exterior angles will only sum to equal 360. So for a 500-sided polygon, the sum of exterior angles is 360 degrees. And if we wanted to find what one of those exterior angles were equal to, we would divide 360 by 500, which is 0.72, a really small angle. And for number 32, is there a regular polygon with an interior angle sum of 9,000 degrees? If so, what is it? An interior angle sum we find using the formula n minus 2 times 180. And we have to see if there is an interior angle sum of 9,000. So we have to see if that is equal to 9,000. So let's divide both sides by 180 and solve for n to get the number of sides of that regular polygon. When we divide by 180, we get that n minus 2 equals 9,000 divided by 180, which is 50. So then we'll add 2 to both sides to get that the number of sides n is equal to 52. So our answer is yes, and that polygon is a regular 52-gon, since the number of sides is 52. And with that final answer, we wrap up the polygons and angles worksheet. If you haven't already, please click that subscribe button and give me a thumbs up. All subscriptions and likes are greatly appreciated. And if you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment below.